Greetings, it's New Zealand naturopath Eric Bakker. I'm the author of Candida Crusher, and I'm also the formulator of a range of supplements called Canxida. Thanks for checking out the video. I've got a question here from a guy called Pakreen in Amsterdam. Pak is asking me, does a low neutrophil count mean I have Candida? Well, Pak, it doesn't necessarily mean you've got Candida. But it can certainly mean that you're going to be more susceptible to a yeast or a bacterial infection. So low neutrophil count is another word we use for it. It's called neutropenia. So what are neutrophils? Well, neutrophils are white blood cells. And we've got two main types of cells in our blood. We've got red cells and white cells. There are different kinds of white cells. A very common one, in fact, I think they make up about 75% of all white blood cells, are called neutrophils. So neutrophils are really like the Marines. These guys are front line. These guys are hand-to-hand combat. So they're going to look for things like bacteria, and they're going to attack the bacteria, and they're going to engulf the bacteria, and they're going to kill them. If bacteria bypass the neutrophil line, if bad guys get past the Marines, then you need to have other guys in the back, or girls, you need soldiers in the background there, basically, to take up the slack. And then we're going to get other kinds of cells. It's going to get more complicated, and we call them the lymphocytes. So the neutrophils, we call cell-mediated immunity, and the lymphocytes, or the specialty guys in the back, these are the artillery. We would call them the humoral immunity. So you've got two main types of immune systems, the front end and the back end. So neutrophils really make up front line. So, if you're going to cut your finger and get bacteria in there, if you're going to get bugs into your system, ear, nose, or throat, or any way that you can ingest them, the neutrophils are going to really help to take them out. So if you've got a low count, you're going to be more susceptible to bacterial infections especially, but also fungal infections. So if a doctor finds that you've got like thrush in the mouth, or you've got sores that don't heal, or you've got fevers, temperatures and sweats and stuff, especially if you've got, lumps and bumps around the body, like lymph nodes that could be up, that could be a sign that you've got neutropenia. But also that you've got a problem also with the back end of the immune system. The lymphocytes could be problematic. So neutrophils themselves don't necessarily give us the same kind of signs in the lymphatic system that the lymphocytes do, with lymph nodes. So I hope that answers your question, Puck, about neutrophils. So how do we get low neutrophils? How does neutropenia occur in the body? Well, some people are genetically susceptible to neutropenia, so they're basically born with low neutrophils. That could be part of their genetic makeup. Many people, however, can get neutropenia from pharmaceutical medications. It's not uncommon to get them from recurring, repeated rounds of antibiotics, different heart medications. I know from experience that thyroid medications, different types, propiothuracil and carbamazole, for example, they can lower neutrophils by default. And different kinds of heart drugs, arrhythmia, anti-arrhythmia drugs, and blood pressure drugs can also have that similar effect on neutrophils. And of course, we classically get that with different chemotherapy treatments can cause neutropenia. So, if you're on medication and you've got neutropenia after you've been on medication, just do a Google search for that drug and check if there's any neutropenia involved, or just check for low neutrophils and then that pharmaceutical medicine to see if there's a link there. And if you worry, talk to your doctor about it. Because some drugs can make you more susceptible to getting fungal and bacterial infections. And that's not a good idea. So I hope that gives you a little bit of insight into low neutrophil count. Thanks for tuning into my video.